Welcome everybody, and this is Mr. Fugu with Mr. Fugu Data Science. I created this channel to allow those who are self-learners or someone such as myself who is a little rusty on a topic to give them a little push. I decided to post all of my scripts and data within GitHub / Mr. Fugu Data Science. Before we get started, I would like to say if you have any questions, concerns, comments, or ideas that you would like me to cover, feel free to provide those in the comment section. I am human and I make mistakes, so please try not to roast me too much in the comment section. I decided to work with dummy data or data generation today because it's very useful in a lot of applications such as populating a database or doing some kind of testing. And specifically, we'll be using address data in Python today. And I wanted to go over a little bit of the pros and cons. If you're unfamiliar with data generator through the package of Faker or the US address parser, I provided the links, as well as the first exercise where you can download many real address CSVs from the US and worldwide. Now, if you've never downloaded these before, you're going to need the pip install Faker and US address. And don't forget the little bash symbol, the bang. All right, everybody? We'll be using the OS pandas US address Faker and CSV, which will be used for exporting and creating our files. I'm using a random seed, so I could replicate these data. Now, to make your time a little more efficient and expand some of your skills, I decided to utilize the OS import. This will assist in a few ways. It allows you to avoid hard coding a physical address for where a file may be, and allows you to look within your directory, expand outside of your directory, or even look in your whole system for a particular file or a class of files, such as a .csv, a .png. Now, the first function I created is letting you maintain a search locally. And basically what you're doing is you're looking within your current working directory, and you're iterating through the directory as a list. And if this path is within your list, you're basically joining them together. You're finding that if it exists, you're concatenating and creating the file that you can call. Now, working from a directory where we're basically searching outside of it and expanding kind of gets a little tricky. And below, I'll show kind of what's going on after this function. But what we're doing is we're saying, okay, let's look at any directory from where we're at. And let's basically walk across the directory from our working directory. All right, and you're thinking, what's going on with this P, N, and F? Well, we'll get to that below, all right? Now, you're basically searching from when you're finding your output directory and you're looking for a string, which is whatever file you're looking for, and this file will be either a full file or just an extension of a file. And that's what's going on here. And then I'm creating a data frame from this. Okay, so let's kind of backtrack and figure out what's going on bit by bit. Okay, so what happens is we're starting from where I'm at, where this current project is here. All right, now, what's happening is we're looking from here at everything that's within it, all right? So we're going layer by layer, basically from outer to inner. So what we had was each directory and then a subdirectory. And then we're saying, well, what's in each subdirectory? And then we're saying, all right, within that subdirectory, what specific files are in this directory? All right, so what you can see is All of these were downloaded CSV files of various cities from different states. Now, ideally, you'd be working with real addresses, but this just says that that's not particularly accurate in the real world. You don't always have a complete address. You don't always have maybe even an address at all. And that's why you have to use fake information. Even fake names, fake IP addresses, depends on what your application is, what you're trying to test or create. Now, in the import US address parser, there's two particular methods that it uses. One which is a tag, and one which is the parse. And these are different. The tagging in the documentation is returned as a smarter type of parser. I don't know what that exactly means. Maybe it means that it, you know, is more definitive in what it parses. Maybe it excludes more things. I'm not really certain. I found that from the file that I imported, which is the Berkeley CSV, I have the street, the number, the unit, the city, and the postal code were the most relevant to me. Fair enough. I had to create a list from my data frame because, in essence, what I need to do is convert from a list of lists into a list of strings that the parser can read. Now, the method of using a tag has a specific formatting as an output, which is an ordered dictionary. That's the specific distinction that we need to remember here. All right. Now, we're using a few functions that I created, and I wanted to go over those briefly. We have a convert, which is taking a list of tuples and creating a dictionary with key value pairs, where the values are a list. Now, we're taking a separate function, which is taking a list and converting it to a list of strings, which is going to be used for the parser. Then, we're going to take that and use the convert function, which takes the parse data, which is converted into a list of tuples, where the first element in the tuple is the key, and the second is the value. And then we have this goofy looking thing where we're taking the data frame and creating a dictionary, where you're basically taking a series, which is a column, and taking every row within that column and iterating. And this is beautiful because if you have data that has no values, for instance, if you're parsing and you end up having mismatched rows, this can be an issue through an error, and this kind of incorporates it. And it's appended to the citations in the bottom where you can look at the code where I got it. Now, this looks specifically at what's going on. The convert function, I'm taking the key and what's the value, and I'm providing an empty default dictionary where I'm appending the key and the empty value, which becomes a list of values. Here's where we have to create the, here's the workhorse of where we're creating the list of strings which are needed. The notation here is looking through the addresses, parsing the addresses, using the tag method to create the ordered dictionary, iterate through the length of it, creating a the ability for me to loop through the ordered dictionary, and appending. Now, here's what the data frame looks like, and it looks like it's pretty good. It doesn't appear that we have any null values for this data set, which is great. I wanted to look independently of what's going on in the inner workings of each of these functions, okay? The parser function here, the output is the street address, which is created from the parser, and this is the physical information that was from my data set, okay? Now, let's look at the different format where we're using the parser, which is just parsing and not the tag option, okay? The difference is we're not creating a order dictionary anymore, which is different. So here's the output of that, which should be the exact same in this scenario. In other data sets, it could be different, where you could have a lot of null values, and we'll show that in the problematic section with dummy data and not real data. So let's look and see what's going on here. From above, we're breaking these up bit by bit, all right? So we're parsing this. We're creating the list of strings. From the list of strings, we take the parser, and we're creating a list of tuples, but in this case it's backwards and we need to switch the order, which is done here. Okay. And then from there, you're using this to create your data frame. Now, let's look at some different pseudo examples of US addresses, which are kind of funky. The first situation we're going to look at here is like doing a CSV dump. So this could be something that you would end up with if you're doing web scraping and you just dumped it to a CSV and you had some weird funky format, right? And you're just like, okay, I just have some raw data. Fine. The second one we're going to be looking at is using the faker package.address, but not dumping it as a CSV and trying to read the data from there. Okay. In each case, we're going to use the parser and the tags. All right. This first function here is where we're calling the fake data generator package. All right. This creates basically your street address, your it creates everything you need for actual physical address and dumps it. You can do it separately for each of these and then store them as columns. And I'll talk about some advantages and disadvantages for each one of these methods at the end. Here's what it would look like for some just random street address. This is interesting because something like this creates a lot of problems for the US street address parser. It can't parse something like this, and I'll show an example at the end. We can go and we can say, okay, let's find another one. Here's another physical address. This is more realistic and something that we could probably parse. Now, what's going on here? We're using a with open and we're dumping this file. Well, let's check and see if this file is actually available yet. So let's go to my desktop. Let's go into projects. And I don't see this yet. I don't see the CSV anywhere. Well, that's because I haven't created it yet. And there we go. I just created it. Now let's look at what it looks like. And let's pretend this was something you web scraped. This is just a string of data. Just string of junk. You could have web scraped something like this and it looked just like this and it wouldn't be formatted at all. So this is actually kind of realistic. I decided to create 6,000 lines or 6,001 lines of data and dumped it out. So let's do something real quick and we'll look at using the regular parser here. And I gave like a general layout of what's going on, of how we're laying this out, but we'll just jump into it. We're doing a, basically we're creating a data frame, putting it into a list, looping through that list and extending it, flattening out the list. Then we're using the parser to create another list. We're switching the orientation of what we have with the tuples within that list, like at the last example, because they're switched, converting into a dictionary and creating the data frame, like the last two examples. All right, now we're looking at the tag format, which is creating the order dictionary. We're using the add parse, which is taking a tag. We're using the convert, which converts the key value pairs where the value is the list of values. We're doing a list comprehension for the data frame, which is at the end like the other ones. And something you should take note, and I'll repeat this again. If you're dealing with NaN values when you're using obscure or pseudo real addresses, you have issues when you're creating your data frame, and that's why the data frame function with the list comprehension is used at the end. All right, now that's a lot to remember, but here we go. So everything looks fine and dandy when you're utilizing this, except one thing goes kind of wonky, and let's find out. Uh-oh, well, why did that happen? Well, because goofy things like these are really hard to parse. And that's one of those goofy situations when you're dealing with fake data that arises. There's a few things that you can do to fix this, all right? The first thing is you can go into the, if you're ambitious enough to go into the Faker GitHub page, do a fork and work with their train test data and try to utilize the problems that you have in a list of data that keep arising with the specific formatting. You have to note that it has to be a real US address, and if you paid attention up there, the address that you're getting is not real for a US address. So I would not suggest going to the GitHub and adjusting their documentation in their package. The other thing is you could create alternatives such as regular expressions to fix this junk. Anyway, this is dumping all of your data that you just created from this fake data into a separate file where I just made some random nonsense. Okay, so here we go. This image allows you to see basically what's going on at one of the fake addresses that came up that does not work with the Faker package using the US address parser. This is something that you would need to account for on your own or neglect it. I don't know what your data situation is. So this is in a large picture of one of the specific examples here. And I left some of the citations of pieces of code that I use to try to put this project together. And I would like to say thank you for watching. Please subscribe and see you in the next video. Thank you.